Well, today we're taking a trip out to Swan Falls Dam. It's about 25 miles maybe south of Meridian, Idaho, where I live. It's a beautiful day, but it's going to get hot this afternoon, so we're trying to get out here before the heat really sets in. Swan Falls Dam was built in 1901. It's a very old dam, and was the very first dam put on the Snake River. And the purpose of the dam, obviously, was to create hydroelectric power for the growing city of Boise. So anyway, here we are. We're almost down to the bottom, and we're going to put the drone up in the air here in a minute and take some video. So anyway, hope you enjoy the video today, and here we go, Swan Falls Dam. So here we are at the Snake River Canyon. There's the dam down there in the distance. Quite a bluff. I mean, I'm thinking the drop is many hundreds of feet, obviously. There's the Snake River flowing on its way from way over in Yellowstone, Wyoming, all the way over to the Columbia River at Tri-Cities, Washington, and then on the way down the Columbia to Astoria and out to sea. So it's a snaky river. So now we're taking the drone and taking a picture upstream, and below you could see the park that we'll visit in a minute. And down there is where our friend Marcus Crawford, who often flies out here, goes and puts his drone over the side at the overlook. And so that's the Snake River on a hot day in late June. Pretty scene, isn't it? Real pretty. There's the Owyhee Mountains in the background. One of my favorite places to take the side-by-side. So in a minute, we're gonna go down to the bottom, and you can see the park down there on the right-hand side of the screen right before the dam. It's a park administered by Idaho Power. And by the way, I called Idaho Power, Bureau of Land Management, and another agency to get permission to come out here to film it. So this is the park. There's the dam, built in 1901. Again, the first dam on the Snake River. Park is well maintained, has bathroom facilities and picnic areas, and again, now we're looking upstream. That's the bluffs over there by the overlook. Crystal clear day, wasn't it? And I don't think there was much wind at all. I sort of had difficulty navigating the trees to get the drone up in the air, but here we go. You can see there was a canopy of trees where I was sitting with on a picnic table, and here we go. We're going to go on the upstream side of the dam. I think those, obviously, those are powerhouses with turbines down below. Here's the effluent on the right, where the river flow is maintained, and I think there must be housing in there for the early construction workers and dam people, because this was quite a trip out here by horse and buggy back in the day when this dam was built. So remember, it was before Henry Ford did his Model T Ford and pickups became on the scene. So there we go. Excuse me. So there's a spillway over there for overflow. Now we're gonna take the drone and fly down to the downstream side of the dam. Beautiful island over there, and
This is where the fishermen come and launch their boats and go bass and crappie and I don't know about trout. I know there's sturgeon in here, and that's the prehistoric fish that lurks in the waters of the Snake River. And it's a catch and release fish. So quite a trophy to catch a sturgeon on the Snake River. There you see the boat launch. Now we're gonna take the drone down and just kind of hunker down to the dam and explore along the edge. They requested that I not fly over the dam, and aside from one time when I forgot, when I was doing a circle around the dam, which you'll see in a little bit, I didn't come even close. Yeah, but shame on me. You can see the water coming down through the opening over there. Nothing going over the spillway. Obviously low water this time of year. Gosh, that drone is fun to fly. This is the Mavic Air 2S, and look at the video quality. I'm just so impressed. My favorite drone of all time. Although I put the Mini 2 up yesterday, and what a hoot that is to fly. There we go, spillways, nothing coming over. I think we do a droney here in a minute. I think that's coming up. Part of it an earthen dam, obviously. Here we go. Up, up, and away, baby. Let's go. Now we're going to go on the upstream side. And go along the edge of the dam. I think we get pretty low and pretty close. I'm getting so I'm more comfortable flying over water. Although obviously you have to be careful. There's the power lines coming out. Yeah, there they are. Quite a structure built in 1901. All right, let's go up in the air. Come on, let's go. Yeah. There we go. It's fun to do maneuvers like that. Obviously, I'm not the world's best pilot, but I'm getting better as time goes by. Sure am. There it is. From about 200 feet, maybe three. Somebody's after me. All right, now we're gonna circle this thing. Put it in a circle mode. Just look at the color that that drone takes video of. It's beautiful. Round and round we go. I used to shoot with a lot of ND filters, but this was a pretty bright day, and I just took the ND filter off, and I think the color's pretty darn good. I really do. Polarizer might have given me a little less glare, but I'll take what I got. Well, this is getting toward the end of this video, but I hope you enjoyed it. Another perspective of the Snake River Canyon. And so please subscribe, leave me comments, and tell others about the channel. Got some more content coming up, another side-by-side ride, and we'll be headed to Priest Lake here in a bit. So get some nice video of the mountains up there in northern Idaho. So. Until then, this is Dr. B saying I'm glad you joined me on this trip. And until next time, I'll see you down the road. Take care.